What's up, guys? How you all doing? So many comments I'm getting. Get a hot knife and cut it to the dry ice. So you ask, you get it. Let's do it and see what happens. Also, a lot of you have been asking to put the glowing knife inside of the liquid nitrogen. Let's do that as well. Let's get to it. Okay, there goes nothing. Hot glowing knife versus dry ice. Whoa! It's just cutting it so easily. Whoa, that's insane. No way a regular knife would cut it through that. It would just not cut at all. It would just stand on it. It just melts it so easily. And I think it's already done, cooled off. Look at that, perfect line. I think we gotta do this again, but lay this glowing knife on a dry ice like this. But when it's glowing, it's still really hot though. Ah, there goes nothing, let's see. That's making such a weird noise. That's insane noise, that's so cool. And I think it's already cooled off. And when it's cooled off, you see it's not cutting anything. This time we're gonna grab liquid nitrogen. Alright, there goes nothing. Whoa! That's crazy. Let's test the temperature on that knife. Look, it's still 300 Fahrenheit on it. Even though we're holding it inside of a liquid nitrogen, look at that. Let's test the temperature. Still 200 Fahrenheit on it. It's actually cooling off really, really slowly. Now let's take it out. 70 degrees still, that's insane. Wow, that's so cool. Well guys, you asked for it, you got it. Hot knife versus dry ice and liquid nitrogen. I think it was pretty cool, so give this video a thumbs up. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.